Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to download and install Visual Studio Code in Windows. So let's get started. First thing, just Google Visual Studio Code and click on the first link, and here you will be having the option for download for Windows. Click here and the download will be getting started. It is about 103 MB in size, so just be patient till the download gets completed. So once the download is complete, just open it and we'll be getting the setup. Just click on I accept. You can just read it through. Click on next, and this is going to be the destination folder where Visual Studio Code is going to get installed. If you want to change it, you can just click on browse and change it. And once you have changed it, just click on next, and this is fine. Click on next, and also make sure that you are checking this create a desktop icon and check these two also. So by this way you will be able to directly right click on a folder and open it by using Visual Studio Code. So it's a good feature. You can just check everything and click on next, and yeah, this is the destination location and every other things that we configured earlier. Click on install. So once the installation is complete, just check this and click on finish. So you'll be getting an interface like this. So now let me show you how you can run a simple HTML file over here. So you can just click on this explorer icon and we'll be having this open folder. So click here and just go to the desired location and open a folder. So I'll just go here and create a new folder like this. Put HTML demo, and you can just click here, select that folder and click select folder. So now automatically we will be having this, and you can just click on yes, I trust the authors. So we are having that folder, but there is no content inside it. So we can just click on this new file and go with the new.html. Alright, so here we can type our HTML code, but the font size is so small, right? So we can just click on this manage, and here we will be having the settings option. Click here, and this is the font size. You can just change this to like 35 or something, I guess. Yeah, that's pretty good. And to get the default boilerplate code in Visual Studio Code, you can just run the exclamatory mark for HTML. So just run this, and as you can see, we are having the emmet abbreviation. Hit on that, so we're getting the default boilerplate code. So I'll just go with some content in the body tag and save it. So there's a simpler way how you can run this. You can just go to extensions, and this is the place where we'll be having all the, you know, extensions. If you are using Python, you can use it. C++, everything is there. In case we want to add AI assistant, you can just install GitHub Copilot too. So I've done an entire video on that, how to add GitHub Copilot. You can just click on the card and check that out. So for HTML, you can just search for live, and you'll be having the live server. Just install and select trust publisher and install, and just look at the download count. So that's amazing. So once it is done, if you go to my HTML code and close this, here we will be having the go live option. So if you click this directly, we will be getting the output, and we can just save and view the output rather than going to the location of this and reopening our HTML file. Just click on go live. So now as you can see, this is the output that we are getting, hello world, and this directly comes from this body tag over here. So that's the video guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.